Hey guys and gals, it's Teddy here at the Digital Showroom at Spinworks. We're located in sunny Tampa Bay, Florida. We love selling motorcycles. This is gonna make my job real easy. This is gonna be a 2011 Can-Am Spyder. This is the RT. It's the Shift Electric, or the SE5. It's gonna have the 1000cc triple cylinder motor, and she's in really good condition. This makes my job very easy. This is what makes my day go by so well. We got a lot of accessories on this one. The condition is good. We're gonna start off with the mileage. Go ahead and take that camera on in there for me, guys. That's gonna be about 14,000 on this one. Now remember, book value always allows 5,000 miles per year. That's gonna be about a three-year-old motorcycle as far as the mileage is gonna go. So for this year, it is a very low mile bike. Does that make it worth more? No. Does it make it desirable? Oh, you bet. So that's why this is gonna be something that if you're in the market for a Can-Am Spyder, this is gonna be one that should be checking a lot of boxes for you. It's gonna have the comfort, the luxury, the miles, the condition. It's all right here. So accessories on this one, it's gonna have some grips on here. They do have a little wear and tear. That's the ugly up front for you right there. Grips are easy to change. Other than that, this is in really good condition. Take a look at the Corbin seats on the back here. These are gonna be done in a spider stitch on here. The pictures are gonna show detailed photos for you. The backrest for the rider and for the passenger all matching in that beautiful blue ribbon with the stitch to match. Really, really nice stuff. On this side of the seat, there is a repair right here, but that is a very expensive Corbin seat. They're in the realm of around $1,300, I believe, for all of what you see right there. Windshield's in excellent condition, very clear. The trunk up front, if you haven't seen these, you got enough room to grocery shop. Check it out. So this one's got a nice felt liner on it. You got tons and tons of room in there, and it's a lockable trunk. So it's really, really nice to have for storage. And speaking of storage on the Can-Am Spyder RT, you're gonna have the trunk up front. You're gonna have the mid, which you also call like a glove box type here. This is where you can put your cell phone, your wallet, change, stuff like that. On this one, it's gonna have the PSI for the suspension, which is really nice. And you're also gonna have a hookup in here for your radio so that you can plug in your phone, hit the Pandora radio, and just go ahead and jam out for your road trip. On the back here, you're gonna have three levers across the back, a left, a right, and a center, and then there's a key at the top, which will lock all three. The center is gonna open up the tour pack. In the back here, this is your big, big trunk, and believe me, let me put my arm in here so you can see it. My arm is straight, and it's about elbow deep, and I'm a tall guy. So you got power supplies back here, lots of storage in here. There's all sorts of accessories that you can get for the trunks on these. And on the left and right side, I'll open up this side so you can see it. There's a cargo net because the bags are concave. They have room to store on the lid. And you got tons of storage in here. Look how deep that is. That's probably close to 10 inches deep, maybe 11. And it's lockable. So you got lots of room to do whatever you want here with the Can-Am Spyders. Let's get over, we'll check out the exhaust sound on this. It's gonna be the sound test. Stay tuned, here we go. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, this is gonna be the sound test on the 2011 Can-Am Spyder. Keep in mind, this is a three-cylinder motorcycle, about 1,000 cc's, five-speed transmission, no clutch, no front brake. You'll see that all of the brakes on the Can-Am Spyders, on most of their models, are going to be controlled with that right there. One foot pedal controls all three of your brakes, front, two up front and one in the rear, and it's anti-lock brakes, which is really cool. So you can smash that pedal as hard as you want and it'll come to a nice, safe, rolling stop. For Spyders, you're gonna turn the key on, you're gonna press mode, and then you go ahead and make sure your kill switch is in the on position, and let's see how she sounds. Here we go. Effortless start. This is a fuel-injected 1000cc. Does have factory exhaust, so it's not gonna be very loud. So if you're worried about upsetting your neighbors or anything like that, don't worry about it. This isn't much noisier than a car or a truck from the factory. Not very loud at all. All of the Can-Am Spyder RTs have a delayed throttle response when they're in park, which, as the gauge is indicating in here, you have a flashing exclamation point. That means, hey, I'm in park, don't go taking off. But it will have a delayed response on here, but once you take them out and ride them, they're instant, good throttle response. But just to give you a sample of what they sound like. rumbly bumbly, nothing crazy though. This is got a nice exhaust note to it. And to be honest, that's not really delayed. That was really nice right there. The gauges on these are laid out really nice as well. You're gonna have your speed on your left, RPM is on the right. You also have a gas gauge on the left-hand side, and then your motor, your temperature is on the right-hand side. And it shows your gear indication on here. You got your radio settings on here. The controls are actually very easy to use. You got an up and down, left and right. So up and down is for your volume, left and right, change your stations. And again, if you run Pandora or any other music application, you just hit it and you're jamming to the music you love anyways. So very easy. One thing that I do want to point out, the parking brakes on here, we get a lot of people asking about these because they go to take off on their Can-Am and it beeps. For instance, if I were to put this on, and just to give you an indication of what that beeping sound is, I just took it out of park right now. So when I turn this key off, you're going to hear that. This beep is a clear indication for you not to get off of your machine. That is letting you know, hey, I'm not in park. Or if you're trying to take off, it will beep at you if it's in park as well. It's saying, hey, parking brake, pay attention to the parking brake. That's what that's indicating. So now when I hit this, it'll lock in park. I hit the key, no noise. So again, if anybody's new to the Can-Ams, you hear that beep, good information for you is check the parking brake. That'll save your parking brake from repairs. So if you hear it beeping, don't go taking off on a road trip. Press that little button that says park on there. If you have any questions about this gorgeous machine, please call us. That number is on the screen for a reason. We sell these very quickly. These are a very high demand motorcycle. So please, if you're interested in this bike, we hate upsetting any of our customers. Our policies are first come, first serve. And whoever puts a deposit on the machine first has first right to the machines. So if you are looking for a Can-Am, I know this is gonna ring a lot of bells for price point for a lot of your potential buyers out there. Please call us, put some money down on it. The video is gonna be accurate on the portrayal and condition of this machine. It's in good condition. Jump on it quick. This one's not gonna last. We sell a lot of these. I know how this sale's gonna go. So give us a shout. Remember that all of our bikes do come with a 30-day powertrain warranty. That's always free. And if you want to put an extended warranty on it, we have it all the way out to 7 years, and we compare that with some of the best financing in the nation. As always, thank you everybody for watching. God bless and ride safe. Thank you.